Statement.
Has this fall camp has gone faster? I mean, you play games, your first games in 8 days from today. Does it feel like it's gone faster?
Yeah, it feels like it's gone really fast, even though it's been longer. But this time of year always goes super fast for me. I'm just thankful we got another week before we start school. I talked to some schools are starting school today, but we got another week without school, which will be really nice. We got time to meet at night. We got time to watch video, and I'm sure football feels the same way. That you don't feel like you're in a panic rush all the time. And starting next week, that's what it'll start feeling like, because you got school and all the other stuff going on.
You made any changes to your captains from last year?
Hang on, I can multitask with the best.
You made any changes to your captains from last year?
No, Merritt and Lexi are captains.
What do you need them to be good at, considering a lot of the same people but some new people? What do you need them to be good at to manage the team this year?
Just do what they've been doing. They take care of the team. They take care of each other. They're great communicators with the coaching staff. They let us know what they need. They worked with Jordan back. Jordan is a captain of the USA team, or I don't know if she was this year, but she has been. But she's their leader. And so she's already started work. They started working with her with stuff. Again, you know, the leaders are setting the direction where we want to go, creating the vision, getting everybody to follow, and keep everybody to stay on task. And those two have, over the last 8 months, 9 months, they've been seasoned, because there's been a lot of challenges, and you know, we've been working on our culture, and so they've gotten some great experience. So they're awesome, awesome captains.
Was there any vote to
no.
reappoint them?
No, we didn't even, it's on their lockers, we're going. We didn't even, you know, and you saw the documentary. I mean, they talked about how important captains are here. So it's an honor to be a captain. We make a big deal about it, and those two, They're leading our team.
What was your reaction to the coach, the ABCA poll that came out today?
Unbothered. You can quote me on that.
Do you hope your players look at it and motivate them at all or anything with it?
No. I don't even know if they know. I mean, they probably could tell you what TikToks were on today, but they probably don't even know that. So we don't even talk about that. If you'd have saw us play Saturday, we're not even maybe top 50 team. So but they came in and they had a hell of a practice today, because they got lit into Saturday. I actually asked Susan over there in football, who dropped more F-bombs, Matt or me, on Saturday? You guys were watching football. Oh, you guys didn't get to watch football. Okay, I was watching football Saturday.
What caused the F-bombs?
We were not focused. We didn't play well. We just didn't execute. We were undisciplined. So those are the things that I don't ever do F-bombs. Well, there's one in the documentary you'll hear, but Becca does way more than I do. But we didn't perform, and we made it a really big game day, and I think they were nervous. And because we made it like a game day, we had uniforms on, and I just think they were nervous. I mean, there's a lot of pressure right now, who's going to play and where they're playing, and they're competing really hard. But it's good we got through it, because I think every year you go through the nervous part. Red White will be a super nervous night, but we got to get through that. So by the time we get to Kentucky, we've got all that out of our system.
How did they respond tonight when you saw them?
Tonight, we had a great practice today. Great. I mean, I saw some things today I hadn't seen in the last first 2 weeks. Really good. And they're, you know, one of our themes is we want them to be great learners, and they learn from Saturday, and we're fixing it today.
You said there's a lot of people who are going to be competing for playing time. You mentioned the depth, that outside hitter. Who has stood out to you? Who's taken a lead during the game?
It all depends on the day. And I've been waiting for somebody to ask me who's the most impressive player so far, or most improved, but nobody's asked yet.
Well, who's the most improved?
Maisie Bosinger. Maisie Bosinger is like made leaps and bounds as a player. Her stats are great. She's doing an awesome job. And I'm not kidding you guys. I mean, I think our two freshmen are right at the level of everybody else. Sometimes by this time they're having a hard time keeping up, but those two have done a really, really good job.
Hey John, last year you had the benefit of a transfer in Merritt coming in and seamlessly, you know, working into the chemistry of your team. When you look at Landfair and Blackwell this year, how has that worked comparatively?
Those two, they're still in a learning curve right now. I don't think, the pace we train at, the drills we're doing. I mean, they're still learning our drills, and I think they're getting them down. But one of them made a comment the other day, like, "What drill's that?" You know, because we call our drills out and go. So they're still learning the drills, trying to figure those things out. But they're both have a chance to play this year. I mean, they're in a chance to start. So they're right there. But I think there's a learning thing there, and a little, you see some of the time they're trying to figure something out. You can see their minds are moving, and we're trying to fine tune both of them to how we train and with footwork and different things. And so they're in a kind of a learning progression here. Like, Krause's heard it for 3 years, so she knows what we're trying to do. Those guys might be hearing it, you know, this is really the first 2 weeks that they've heard it. So there's a learning progression with them, but they're very talented, experienced players.
How much will the red-right scrimmage kind of help narrow things down in terms of rotation of players?
That's a good question. The red-white always, it tells us a lot sometimes, and I haven't still decided how we're going to do it. If we're going to make two even teams, we're going to have an A side, B side. I just haven't decided yet. I'm just kind of, we've had two really good scrimmages that we have some stats on and how they did. And again, they were different teams. So I haven't got there yet. It's Monday.
What are you looking at as options behind Merritt on the right side?
We're training all the outside hitters are learning both positions. So we're training everybody over there because, you know, in one rotation, they all have to hit on the right side. So anyway, they're doing everything over there on both sides. And again, it makes them better volleyball players just to be able to go in those positions.
Going back to the poll, did you ever in your younger coaching days care about preseason polls, and have you ever used it as a motivator?
There's only one time I cared about it. This is a history lesson. It's also in the documentary, by the way. In 2000, we were ranked 12th. We were the lowest preseason ranking ever. It was my first year here. And my quote was, if there's 11 teams better than us, it's going to be a hell of a year in college volleyball. Because we starting off and we're the lowest ranked ever. And we went undefeated and won the national championship. So it's the only time I cared about it. After that, I never cared about it anymore. Same with being selected Big Ten. I mean, it really doesn't matter. It's what you're going to go do.
How has Jordan worked her way back into coaching?
Awesome. She is a gym rat. She sees things so well, and she just has a very calming influence how she communicates with the players. So it's I've been very impressed with her. And you know, she just flew in, she gets a car accident, flies here, and starts on Wednesday. So I mean, she's sleep deprived, she's banged up, and she's hit the ground running. And I'm very impressed. Feel very grateful that she's a part of this, and I think when she says something to our players, I mean, they really believe it.
Now that her pro career is kind of winding down, I mean, do you foresee her having a much bigger role in recruiting moving forward?
I hope so, yeah. I mean, she's signed up for this Love Volleyball, which we've talked about, so that'll be a kind of a conflict, but she's also going to be in front of all those kids because she feels like she has a great platform being in that. She's going in that not to make money or play anymore. She's going there because she's got a great platform to help sport of volleyball grow and make a difference. And that's kind of, I think, her motivation for that.
What stats from Maisie have really improved from?
She's one or two passing every day. She's serving great. She's digging great. Last year I put her in when we needed her. Now, I mean, she's in everything, and she's elevating whatever side she's on. So I've been really impressed with her.
In the spring, you said you really challenged Lexi and Merritt to elevate their game even more as All-Americans. Have you seen that so far this fall?
They're definitely at a different level than they were last year. So we got to see when we play games, but that's in practice. But they have to be in practice because our gym's pretty competitive. But they've got a confidence and about them, and they know what they need to do. And again, I would pay to watch Lexi pass balls. I mean, it'd be like Tommy's here, so it'd be like watching Ernie Els hit golf balls. When you watch him, he's like so smooth. It's like he makes it look so easy. That's what Lexi does. Or watching Steph Curry shoot threes. They just make it look easy. Everybody else, it's harder than heck, and she just makes it look so easy. It's fun to watch.
You said there were going to be nerves on Saturday. Is that something you try to coach them through, communicate it, or just see how they handle it?
No, we talk about how to control that and breathe through it and mentally prepare for it. But till you get out there, it's, yes, Jordan. Her most nervous she's ever been in her career was her first red white. So it's nerve wracking because it's their first time. It's our first match really. We're in sold out. There's going to be other stuff going on. We're going to have so there's a lot of distractions too. But that's why they got to, lock it in.
Thank you.